गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू योर कंप्यूटर क्लासरूम। एज इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट फॉर्मेटिंग, टू टाइप्स ऑफ फॉर्मेटिंग, लॉजिकल एंड फिजिकल, एज वेल एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट बोल्ड, इटैलिक, अंडरलाइन and subscript, superscript and typewriter text. So let's revise them first and then we will talk about the next topic. So coming to the textbook, formatting, logical style and physical style. Logical style allow a browser to interpret the tag based on browser setting. Relative to other text on a web page. In this, I have told you that H2 heading should be larger than the regular font and H1 should be bigger than H2. Like a strong tag is another logical style tag which indicates that the text should have a strong emphasis and for which most browsers interpret and display the text in bold font. Physical style tag specify a particular font change that is interpreted strictly by all browsers. For example, to ensure that text appears in bold font, you will enclose it between a start B and end with a closing tag B tag. So, physical style and logical style. Logical style gives the information about the text, okay? And physical style shows the meaning of the text related to the appearance. Like bold, italic and underlined text. So if you want to change the appearance of your text for denoting some important information regarding some important words, important line, you can use bold, italic and underline. For bold, you will use B tag. For italic, you will use I. And for underline, you will use U. Coming to the next, strike, subscript, superscript and typewriter style text. Strike through, I have told you, you write some words and strike a horizontal line on it. Strike through. Subscript and superscript. Likewise, sub stands for subscript. This tag is used to display the specified text below the normal text. Some specified text for below the normal text, and for that there is example H sub 2 sub O. So you have to make 2 as a small text. So we will write sub and then 2 and then backslash sub. If you want that H should be small, then before H we will write sub and after backslash sub. Superscript. Sub stands for superscript. This tag is used to display the specified text above the normal text. In subscript, the text will be below the normal text, but in superscript, the text will be above the normal text. O sub 2 backslash sub is a square of O and will give O2 as an input. Now, here you can see subscript in front of the text you want to appear in subscript. Type backslash sub at the end of the text, the same as superscript. Typewriter text, for typewriter text, TT in front of the text you want to appear in typewriter, it set the fixed width of the text. Typewriter style text is used to fix the width of the text. Now, centering the text. So how you align your text in center of a web page? Centering the text. You can emphasize on some important information by centering the text. Type center in front of the text you want to align in the center, and type backslash center at the end of the text you want to align in the center. As you can see in the text editor, here HTML head title center text head body. So in the H1 heading we have used center tag and backslash center tag for aligning our text in the center computer system. So in the result web browser you can see computer system is aligned in center. So while using center tag you can align your text anywhere in the web page. Okay, the text is centered on the web page in the web browser. So very easily with the help of center tag we can align our text in center. Now coming to the next, changing font of text. You can change the appearance of your text using tags, font and backslash font along with the face attribute. We should specify more than one font while changing the font, as it comes handy if one font is missing on a user's computer, the text can be displayed with another font you have specified. One of the fonts you specify should be a common font such as Arial, Times New Roman, etc. So you can change the appearance of your text, the look, style of your text with the help of font tag and along with the face attribute. With font tag along with the face attribute you can change the appearance of a text very easily. Like there are some common fonts: Arial, Times New Roman, Calibri, Comic Sans, Elephant. These are the common font name. So it is not difficult to change the appearance of a font, as we think that how we will change the text of our font if we want. So you can see type font face. Font face equals to in front of the text you want to change, means whichever text you want to change in front of that you will write font face, then type the name of the font you want to use. See, H1 center tag you have used computer system. Next, in paragraph, font face equals to Comic Sans MS. Comic Sans MS. So this is the name of the font, and this is the font tag along with face attribute you are using. So Comic Sans font name, and this is the tag in front of which a computer is an electronic machine that works under the instructions given by you. It can accept data input. This is a statement in front of that you are using font face equals to Comic Sans MS. Now next, you can see Comic Sans MS, comma, Arial. So here it has symbolized that to specify the second font, type a comma and then press space bar from the keyboard, then type the second font choice. Type double inverted comma arrow to complete the font tag. Here, if you want more than one font, then you have to use space bar by putting a comma and then write the name of another font and close with a double inverted comma and arrow sign. As you can see here that Comic Sans MS, here it is written, okay, and Arial, here it is written. So at next I will show you, for this there is a comma, Arial, double inverted comma, arrow bracket, and here is another Comic Sans MS, means two font are used for changing the appearance of your text. Okay, now see, font face inverted double inverted Comic Sans MS, comma, Arial, double inverted comma, and then after completing your statement, at last you have to close the font tag with the backslash font. Clear? Because it is also a container tag, so you have both opening and closing tag. Students, remember, if you do not put a backslash font tag here, like for example here you have not written backslash font, so these fonts will applicable to the whole statement and paragraph. Comic Sans MS, comma, Arial will applicable to the whole paragraph, whether there are two paragraphs or three paragraphs. But instead of that, if you have written this one here, so it will not applicable to these or this, it will for this statements only. Clear? It will not affect the next two paragraphs if you have written backslash font here. It will work for only the first paragraph. Clear? So it is compulsory to write till where you want the font face change. After that you have to use backslash font tag as a closing tag. Now see the result displayed in web browser. Computer system. A computer is an electronic machine that works under the instruction given by you. It can accept data, manipulate the data according to the specified rules, process, produce results output, and store the results for future use. So see, the text is not changed. Here it is your regular normal text, and here the changed text. If you have not used your font backslash font there, then these also looks same as this, like the font appearing in this, they also look same, but you have used backslash font, so that's why these are in their regular normal text and this has changed. Clear? As it can be seen, the text is displayed in the font you have specified in HTML code. So very easily, just you have to write font face equals to double inverted comma, font name. If you want one another font, then comma, press space bar, then write the name of the font, and then a double inverted comma and bracket close. Until where you want that appearance should be there, after that you close with a backslash font. Okay. Now you can see, when using headings to organize content and emphasize key points on web page, make sure to use headings consistently. That is, if you use a heading 2 style for a specific level of text, you always should use a heading 2 style to break up information at the level. Do not skip levels of heading in your document. For example, do not start with heading 1 style and then use heading 3. You can see over here what is written, that you cannot skip the levels of heading while using in a web page. First you have used H1 and then next you are using H3. So it is not acceptable in web page. You have to work with the continue level, means H1, H2, H3, H4, H5 and H6. Okay, you cannot skip the level. Clear? Now changing the size of text, as you have changed the alignment of the text in center, you have changed the appearance of the text. Now here you can change the size of the text also. You can change the size of the text on your web page just as you can change the font of the text. You can even change the size of individual text on your web page. So here you can see font size 1, font size 2, font size 3, font size 4, font size 5, 6, 7, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and with a closing tag here. Okay, so for a single text you are using different font sizes. Okay, so while writing font size equals to double inverted comma 1, PM publishers, you change the size of this text. So as you can see, very easily we are changing the size, appearance, alignment of the text just with the little change in the writing style of the text. Simple. As you can see, earlier we have used font फेस फॉर चेंजिंग द अपियरेंस ऑफ द टेक्स्ट एंड हियर व्हाट वी आर यूजिंग फॉन्ट साइज SIZE साइज. सो विद द हेल्प ऑफ फॉन्ट साइजेस यू कैन चेंज द साइज ऑफ योर टेक्स्ट. टाइप फॉन्ट साइज इन फ्रंट ऑफ द टेक्स्ट यू वॉन्ट टू चेंज टू अ न्यू फॉन्ट साइज. रिप्लेस क्वेश्चन मार्क विद द नंबर्स फ्रॉम 1 to 7. द स्मॉलेस्ट फॉन्ट साइज इज 1 एंड द लार्जेस्ट इज 7. स्मॉलेस्ट इज 1 एंड लार्जेस्ट इज 7. टाइप बैकस्लैश फॉन्ट एट द एंड ऑफ द टेक्स्ट यू वॉन्ट टू चेंज. सो सी एवरीवेयर यू हैव टू क्लोज योर फॉन्ट. टू चेंज द बेस फॉन्ट ऑफ द एंटायर टेक्स्ट ऑन द पेज टाइप द बेस फॉन्ट साइज बिफोर द टेक्स्ट ऑन योर वेब पेज. विद अ नंबर फ्रॉम 1 to 7 द स्मॉलेस्ट साइज इज 1 एंड द लार्जेस्ट साइज इज 7. वॉट इज बेस फॉन्ट? ओके, ओके. समटाइम्स व्हाइल स्क्रॉलिंग द पेज अप्स डाउन्स वेरी फास्ट. ओके, सो डोंट वरी. सो व्हाइल वी हैव यूज्ड डिफरेंट फॉन्ट साइजेस यू कैन सी द रिजल्ट ओवर हियर. स्मॉलर, बिगर एंड देन एट लास्ट द बिगेस्ट बिकॉज लास्ट साइज इज 7. सो फ्रॉम 1 to 7. ओके, नाउ आई हैव आस्क्ड यू बेस फॉन्ट. ओके, बेस फॉन्ट इज यूज्ड फॉर डिफॉल्ट वैल्यू ऑफ द टेक्स्ट साइज, कलर एंड फॉन्ट फेस फॉर द होल टेक्स्ट इन अ वेब पेज. लाइक इफ यू हैव यूज्ड अ बेस फॉन्ट ओवर हियर सो इट हैज इट्स ओन डिफॉल्ट वैल्यू फॉर द फॉन्ट साइज, फॉर द फॉन्ट फेस एंड color also for whole document in a web page. But font size or font tag is used to change the appearance or size of the text enclosed in a bracket. Here you can see enclosed in a bracket means whatever text is written in this. So font size equals to 2 PM publisher's font. It is enclosed in a bracket between the font tag. But in base font, the default value is there, which applicable for whole document. Clear? I hope this will be clear to you all, the size and font face. Now coming, changing the color of text. So you can change the color of the text also. Like you have changed the size, the font face, so you can also change the color as the user requirement or as you want. Black, red, pink. There are different codes for changing the color in HTML. You can change the color of entire text of your web page, just as you can change the font of text to change the appearance of your web page. The color attribute works with font tag. Change text on a page from default black to a color. So default black color to a color means, what is the default color of HTML? Text black. So you can change it to a color. In the body tag, type text, replacing question mark with the name or code for the color you want to use.
For example, if you wish to have the color of the text in red, then type body text equals to double inverted comma hash FF 0000. So this is the text. To change the color red, this is the code which you will write for changing the text color from black to red. Let's see. Body text double inverted comma hash FF 0000. Let's see what's the result come. See, the whole document text color changed from black to red. See, very easily, just you have written under the body text and then the color code. There are codes assigned to each color, and the color code is in hexadecimal format. These color codes are in hexadecimal format. As you know that computer understands a machine language which is in binary from 0 and 1. So in that, decimal, hexadecimal, octa. So there is a 16 colors which you can specify by name also. Aqua hash 00 FFFF, gray hash 808080, navy, silver, black, green, olive, teal, blue, lime, purple, white, fuchsia, maroon, red, yellow. So while changing the color of your text, you will use these codes. Here name is given and code is given. See, name and in front of that code. So you have to remember these codes while writing. There is another an option that some of the colors you can write instead of code, you can directly write the name also. That will also change the color of your text. So this is, you have written body text. As if you want to change a particular color of a single text or a paragraph, not the whole document, then you will use font color. Font color color equals to double inverted comma, like you have written red. Okay, and close with backslash font. So it will what? Change the color of your text which you want, not the whole document. Okay, if you have written inside the body tag, then it will change the color of your whole document, the text which were there. But if you have to change the color of your specific word or line, then you will use font color equals to whatever color you want. You can write the code of that color or the name of that color. Then your text which you want to change in different colors, and then at last close the font tag. Okay, attribute and value. Color equals to hash XXXXX. What is the function of this? Changes the font color. Value inside quotation marks is 6-digit color code and color name. Changes font face or type, face, font name, This changes the font face or type. Value inside quotation mark is the name of the font, such as Vardhana and Arial. Text appears using the default font if the font face is not specified. If you have not specified the font face, then by default, what will be the font face? Vardhana and or Arial. These are the default font faces. And color, of course, the default color is black. So hope whatever I told you, you have understood. Revise it, practice it. Okay, there will be a practical session video also, in which I will show you the working of each and every tag. Okay, so don't worry, read the chapter, revise it, and then when you will get a practical video, practice it on your PC or laptop. In the next class, we will go through with changing the part of text color, okay, which I have told you today also. Then we will read it in a brief. Part of color, background color of page, and then we will come to the question answers, okay, and the chapter will be completed. Clear? Okay, thank you.